Children, let us continue the chapter triangle. Now let us start the exercise 3. The first question, triangle ABC and triangle DBC are two isosceles triangles on the same base BC and vertices A and D are on the same side of BC. If AD is extended to intersect BC at P, show that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD and triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. AB bisects angle A as well as angle D. Fourth one, AP is the perpendicular bisector of BC. These are the four points need to be proved. Now, here what is given? Triangle ABC and triangle DBC are isosceles triangles on the same base BC. Here the triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Given that AB is equals to AC, let us consider. And triangle DBC is also isosceles triangle with BD equals DC. Because they are on the same base BC, so you have to consider AB equals AC and BD equals DC. So you take AB equals AC and BD equals DC. AD is extended to produce BC at P. First one, what you have to prove? Triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD and next triangle ABP congruent to triangle ACP. So what is given here? Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equals AC and next triangle DBC is an isosceles triangle with DB equals DC. That much is given. Now you take the triangles. What we have to prove? Triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. You take the names of the two triangles. In triangle ABD, that is for the first one. In triangle ABD and triangle ACD. Triangle ACD, what are equal? It is given that AB equals AC, that is given, and also BD equals DC, that is also given, and you can observe that AD is a side of both the triangle, that is the common side. So you write AD equals AD, common side. Then you can write triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD according to which congruence rule? Here three sides you have taken, therefore you write SSS. So which congruence rule? SSS congruence rule. According to SSS congruence rule, you can write that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Now you take next one. Triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. Here to prove this, you will get AB is equals to AC already given and AP equals AP common side you can take. But here you need one more side or one more angle. You can have that angle BAP equals angle CAP. As you proved, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Here angle BAD equals angle CAD, you can write that is nothing but angle BAP and angle CAP, and AD becomes the bisector of the angle A. So you now write, therefore according to CPCT, what you can write here, you write according to CPCT, therefore angle BAD or BAP, angle BAD equals angle CAD, that is nothing but BAP and CAP. So according to CPCT, so then you can say that AD is a bisector of the angle A, that is angle BAC. Here what is given, AB here, what you have to write, AB is a AP is a bisect of the angle A. So you write that as, therefore AP is a bisector of angle A. Angle A, one thing you got here. Next, here you got the first point, this is the second point, that is third point you got here. This is the third point. Now here what you have to prove, triangle BPD is congruent to triangle CPD. So you write the names of the two triangles. In triangle BPD and triangle CPD, triangle CPD, so you write, next what you have to prove, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. You write the names of the triangle. In triangle ABP and triangle ACP, you write AB equals AC given. AB equals AC given, and also AP equals AP common side. AP equals AP common side, that is the side of both the triangle ABP and ACP, common side, common side. Then also you write what is given, angle BAP equals angle CAP is proved. BAD is nothing but angle BAP, so you write angle BAP equals angle CAP, that is proved. You consider this is which one, first one you take, that is first one from first. Here BAD and BAP are same, that is AD is extended to P, CAD and CAP are also same. Therefore you can write, therefore triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. So according to which congruence rule, side angle side, so you write according to, therefore that is according to SAS congruence rule, SAS congruence rule. You got the second one also, second one you got. Now AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. Here then you can say that this BPD is also congruent to triangle CPD. How you can prove? Here you can prove that as triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP, therefore you write BP equals PC, BP equals PC, that is CPCT, according to CPCT. As triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP, BP must be equals to PC. You got that P is a midpoint of BC, so AP bisects BC, but we have to show that AP bisects perpendicularly. Here AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. That you have to show. Now here you take the triangle DBP and DCP, and prove that they are congruent. If you prove that they are congruent, then you will get here angle DPB equals to angle DPC. That sum is 180, and 180 is divided into two equal parts. You will get 90, 90, and as angle P is 90 degree, then you can say that AP perpendicular to BC and AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. And also you have to prove that here this AP bisects angle D. Again you have to show that angle BPD must be equals to angle C, angle BDP must be equals to angle CDP, angle BDP must be equals to angle CDP. That also you have to prove. Therefore you take the triangles DBP and triangle CDP. So you take write the names of the triangle. In triangle DBP and triangle DCP, triangle DCP. So what is given here? DB equals DC is given. DB equals DC, that is given. And also you can write that angle DBP must be equals to angle DCP. They are the angles opposite to equal sides. Angles opposite to equal sides. Equal sides. And also you proved BP equals PC. BP equals PC. Consider this is the second. Here there is a first, so you take this is the second. That is from second, we proved this. Therefore you can write that triangle DBP is congruent to triangle DCP. According to which congruence rule? You know that side angle side. So write according to side angle side. SCAS congruence rule. SCAS congruence rule. Then you can say that angle BDP must be equals to angle CDP according to CPCT. Therefore you can say that AP is a bisector of angle BDC. AP is a bisector of angle BDC. We got that one. And also here angle and angle DPB must be equals to angle DPC. That is also according to CPCT. And their sum is 180 degree. As there is a linear pair, you write angle DPB plus angle DPC equals to 180 degree. The reason is linear pair. You write there is a linear pair. Angle DPB plus angle DPC equals 180 degree. There is a linear pair. So you can have that angle DPB equals angle DPC, both are equals to what? 180 by 2. Here the sum is 180 degree, means you must divide 180 into two equal parts. So it is 180 by 2, both are equals to 90 degree. Therefore you can write AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. Therefore AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. AP is a perpendicular bisector of BC. Here we got 4 points. First one, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD, first here. Then second, triangle ABP is congruent to triangle this one. And next, also here AP is a bisector of angle A as angle BAD is equals to angle CAD. And also it is a bisector of D as angle BDP is equals to angle CDP. And also AP is the perpendicular bisector of angle BC. Here you got it. Lastly, in this way you got the result. Now the second question. AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC in which AB equals AC. Show that first one, AD bisects BC. Second one, AD bisects angle A. So here what is given? ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equals AC. What you have to show? You have to show that AD bisects BC, AD bisects angle A, and also it is given that AD is the altitude. Here AD is the altitude. Now let us take the solution. So what is given here? Given that in triangle ABC, AB equals AC and AD perpendicular to BC. AD perpendicular to BC. Now here first we have to show that AD bisects BC, means we have to show that BD is equals to DC. That you have to show. How you can show that BD is equals to DC? You take the triangle ADB and ADC, prove that they are congruent. If you prove they are congruent, you can write that BD is equals to DC according to CPCT. And also AD bisects angle A means angle BAD becomes equals to angle CAD according to CPCT. Then you can say that angle A is bisected by AD. That is AD bisects angle A. Now you write the names of the triangle ADB and triangle ADC. In triangle ADB and triangle ADC, it is given that AD is the altitude, means AD is perpendicular to BC. So you take in the right angle triangle. In right angle triangle, triangles ADB and ADC, you write AB equals AC. That is given. That is the hypotenuse. Here they are the hypotenuse also, right? Hypotenuse AB equals hypotenuse AC. Then also you can say that AD equals AD common side. AD equals AD common side. So according to RHS postulate, you can say that triangle ADB is congruent to triangle ADC. You know that in two right angle triangle, if hypotenuse of one triangle is equals to the hypotenuse of the other, and also one side of one triangle is equals to the one side of the other, then those two triangles are congruent. Therefore you write triangle ADB is congruent to right angle triangle ADC. That is according to RHS congruence rule. according to RHS congruence rule. And you got that triangle ADB is congruent to triangle ADC. Therefore, you can write angle BAD equals angle CAD, and also here BD equals DC. You write BD equals DC, and also angle BAD equals angle BAD equals angle CAD according to, what is the reason here? The reason is CPCT. Common reason you can give CPCT. Then as BD equals DC, as BD equals DC, AD bisects BC. AD bisects BC, and as angle BAD equals angle CAD, here angle BAD equals angle CAD, you got, as that two angles are equals, you can clear that AD bisects angle A also, because they, those two angles are the angles made by the AD of the angle BAC. So you can say that AD bisects angle A. AD bisects angle A. Next, third question. What is that third question? Two sides AB and BC and median AM of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to sides PQ and QR and median PN of triangle PQR. Show that, first one, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. Second one, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So what is given here? Given that AB is equals to PQ and BC is equals to QR and AM is equals to PN. That much is given. AB, BC and AM of triangle ABC are respectively equal to the PQ, QR and MPN of the triangle PQR. So that much is given. You take that one. Take the solution. Given, it is given AB equals PQ and BC equals QR and AM equals PN. As BC equals QR, also you can take half of BC equals half of QR, that is from this one. You can take half of BC equals half of QR. Half of BC is BM equals what? QN. So you got these three is first and you got the result. This is the second. Here, as BC equals QR, half of BC equals half of QR. Half of BC you can take BM or CM. Half of QR you can take QN or NR. Now first thing what you have to prove, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. So you write the names of the two triangles. In triangle ABM and triangle PQN. Which are the equal parts? You can write ABM and PQN. ABM and PQN. And it is given AB is equals to PQ and AM is equals to PN, and also BM is equals to QN. These two are from the first, that is given. You can take the reason you can give given or from first. From first, this is from second. As BC equals QR, half of BC equals half of QR. Therefore, you can write BM is equals to QN. Then you can write, therefore, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. Triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. According to which congruence rule? That is, you know that side. SSS congruence rule. SSS congruence rule. SSS congruence rule. Next you take here. The next one is what you have to prove. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. As triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN, you can write angle B equals angle Q. Consider that is the third. So you write the reason, that is CPCT. Why you have taken this? Here to prove that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, this is required because you know that AB is equals to PQ and BC is equals to QR and angle B is equals to angle Q. If you take according to SSS congruence rule, you got that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Therefore, this angle B equals angle Q, you got from the congruent parts of the corresponding parts of the congruent triangle, triangle ABM and triangle PQN. Therefore, here angle B equals angle Q is required. Now, to prove that triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR, write the names of the triangle ABC and triangle PQR. So, you write in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR and triangle PQR. Here what is given? It is given that AB is equals to PQ. You write AB is equals to PQ and BC is equals to QR. That is given, or you can write the reason from first, that is taken here. From first you can take. From first. The next angle B equals angle Q, that is from third. Reason you can write from third, that is the CPCT of the A triangle ABM congruent to triangle PQN. So you can write that is from third. We proved that one. Now you can write therefore triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. According to which postulate? SAS. Side angle side. Here according to SAS congruence rule, you can write that, right? SAS congruence rule. Fourth question, BE and CF are two equal altitudes of a triangle ABC. Using RHS congruence rule, prove that the triangle ABC is isosceles. Means we have to prove that AB equals AC, we have to prove. Now here it is given that CF and BE and CF are altitudes and they are equal. Means CF perpendicular to AB, BE perpendicular to AC. Take that solution. What is given in the figure, or given that you write given that BE perpendicular to AC and CF perpendicular to AB. CF perpendicular to AB. Then also it is given BE equals CF. BE equals CF. Now you take the triangle BFC, that is the right angle triangle, and also triangle BEC. Triangle BEC are the right angle triangle. Triangle BFC and triangle BCE. So you take in triangle BFC, there is the right angle triangle. In right angled triangles BFC and BEC, which are the equal parts, you can write the hypotenuse is BC, that is the common side. So hypotenuse BC equals hypotenuse BC, common side. Then also you can write BE equals CF, means CF equals BE. CF equals BE, that is given, you can write given. Then you can write that therefore right angle triangle BFC is congruent to right angle triangle BEC according to RHS congruence rule. RHS congruence rule. Therefore you can have here angle B means angle FBC must be equals to angle ECB according to CPCT. Therefore you write angle FBC equals angle ECB. Angle ECB according to CPCT. Then in triangle ABC, AB and AC are the sides opposite to the equal angles ABC and ACB, because FBC means that is nothing but angle ABC. FBC means that is nothing but angle ABC, and BC means angle ACB. Therefore AB is equals to AC. So you can take therefore in triangle ABC, AB equals AC because AB and AC are the, or you write sides opposite to the equal sides are equal, equal angles are equal, sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Therefore, you can write that triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Therefore, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. So, you proved that triangle ABC is isosceles. Fifth question, ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equals AC. Draw AP perpendicular to BC. Show that angle B equals angle C. Now, write the solution. What is given here? In triangle ABC, AB equals AC. right? In triangle ABC, AB equals AC. That is given, and also it is given AP is drawn perpendicular to BC. So you got two triangles here, triangle APB and triangle APC. Both are right angle triangle as AP is perpendicular to BC. As AP perpendicular to BC, triangle APB and triangle APC are right angled triangle. So write in right angled triangle, in right angled triangles, APB and APC. You know that AB is the hypotenuse in the triangle, right angle triangle APB. AC is the hypotenuse in the right angle triangle APC. It is given that AB is equals to AC. So you write hypotenuse AB equals hypotenuse AC. That is given. It is given. Now also here common side is there. Which is the common side? AP. AP equals AP. AP is the side of both the triangle. So you write AP equals AP. Then you write that is the common side. That is the common side. Then you can write therefore right angle triangle APB is congruent to right angle triangle APC. As these two triangles are congruent, you can write that angle B equals angle C according to CPCT. Angle B equals angle C. Here which congruence rule? That is RHS congruence rule. RHS congruence rule. And here what is the reason you are going to give? As angle B equals angle C, that is the reason is CPCT. As triangle APB is congruent to triangle APC, angle B must be equals to angle C according to corresponding parts of congruent triangle CPCT. You got the result.